Right, this is Sheila, and it's 2010, it's September the 2nd now, and basically I'm doing a cassette recording with photos that I did when I visited a place called Crowhurst, which is recorded in history as a small village that was attacked quite ferociously by William the Conqueror prior to the Battle of Hastings. Anyway, I decided to go and have a look for myself, which is what I did during my ancestral trail trip. So here we go, over to the cassette recording.
Right, I'm camping in a place called Cobb Farm, and it's just up the road is the famous village of Crowhurst. Although I just spoke to some people from Hastings who never realised the significance of Crowhurst. Anyway, I've just taken some pictures. I've got to this place. It's where a great battle happened in all the villages. One of the first battles that happened when the Conqueror landed here. And he killed most of the villagers, and for some reason, I don't know why they chose this, place, Crowhurst. Apparently that's what happened. There's a walk along here. Hold on a minute. Anyway, I've got to make the most of the time I've got, because I might not be able to camp here. It's fortunate it was just in the back garden of the farm. And that ruin there, why have a big ruin in a little place like this unless it's not a monument to what happened here? It's the evening. It's Friday evening of the 30th of July, and I discovered that a place called Crowhurst, which is linked to William the Conqueror when he first came over, where there was a slaughter of the villagers. A big slaughter. And some women were taken away and all sorts of things. What happened in those days. And it was recorded. A lot of people don't realise. Anyway, it's called the Parish Church of St. George Crowhurst. I should take a picture of it. Okay. through some bits of information inside the church. But we're actually the lights on. I ought to go in there. There's some sort of gardens. Remember, the lights are on. It could be like you get inside. Bloody angle I came from, isn't it? The church. I'm talking with my... I still think I'm talking into the video, you know. I'm talking away. I think the video's on the mobile. I'm going to get lost on the way back. I can't be too long. So it gets dark and I get lost in this country lanes. I notice round here they have very stubby footstones, or they could be the main stones for graves here. Very thick and solid. In Sussex, they have very stumpy, very solid stumpy stones. Because you can't read anything on them. I ought to try and get in the church, really, or there's somebody in there. They might not let me in. Oh my God, look at that tree. Never seen anything like it. People are sitting inside. Thomas Papillon of Acrest Place, Kent and Crowhurst Park, Sussex, born 1803, died 1883, also Frances Margaret Papillon, daughter of Sir Henry Oxted, 7th Bart. That's a big plaque to them. There's a very, very old tree as well. Hundreds of years old, that could. Look at that. It's massive. Very spooky. I'm taking pictures. You are very old, aren't you? God. From the fact that the Conqueror came here. I mean, the Stutfels might have came with him, the Declarers might have come with him. You know, apart from that, is no link, but it is... There is a link because of the Conqueror coming here, and this is featured in history. It's a very good photo as well, that church does. I mean, we could come across any moons just by casually walking around, it'll be fine, but there's an old bridge on wood. Imagine if I had any woods here. I'd like to go inside the church, so there's a possibility. If I don't know, I might stay another night. It'd be nice to stay one more night, really. It's only £12. So I'm dreading the time when I got to sleep in the car, because that could happen when I get short of money. I'm trying to be economical, but money just goes. I had to buy myself a souvenir, didn't I, today? I bought a nice, heavy metal paperweight of a knight's hat, the helmet. Yeah, I'll take another picture, another angle of it. I mean, when am I going to come back to do this again? You know, it's all right saying, oh, you know, you might come back. I mean, I'm 58. That's the first time I've been to the battlefield of William the Conqueror. So, it's quite likely I should never come back in my life again. As they're all into there, I've noticed there's lots of shields. The kids build shields and things, and the schools it around here. It's the sort of thing you do, isn't it? Cooks. Yeah, I'd like to go inside, but I'll come back tomorrow. I'll come back tomorrow and look. I'm not going to disturb someone. I think they've practiced them at the wedding. I don't want to get lost anyway. So, yeah, that's what I'll have to come back tomorrow, because the thing is, I've had to come down some very windy lanes, and already I can't remember which way I came. So, I think I've a rough idea. Some really old graves here, I'll tell you. Very old. Yeah, what I want to do, I want to get back on the main road so I can at least go into Beck's Hill. Because I know it's a main road, but if I get it stuck in the dark and these lanes here, I'll never find my way out of them. That happened to me once before, and it frightened the life out of me in Cornwall when that happened. So it's high hedges and it gets very dark. And this is all going on the family tree in one shape or another. So what beyond the... Well, Zora talks about a blog and all that. I might be able to put my videos on. I didn't do a video of that. Right, I better go before I get... I still want to get lost. Right, I think it's the 1st of August today. It's my granddaughter's birthday, Corinne. She'll be 14 today. I sent her a card. And I'm going to get her something. Or I'm going to give her some money when I get back. Happy birthday, Corinne. Right, well, I stayed at this campsite. Oh, let me just see what it's called. It's called Great Buckhurst Campsite. Blue Moon's Lane, Settlecombe. It's not far from Hastings. Well, yeah, it's not far from Hastings. So I've got her card. I've got a card for that. That I need to put somewhere. Anyway, the plan today is to head up the A21, then onto the A2, with a B or A227 to Wood Ickham and places at that to do a bit more ollie stuff before heading for Southwark. Right, I'm gonna... What else can I say? Yeah, it's, yeah, it rained overnight. I had to sleep in a tent that was wet. Everything was wet last night. My, quilt was wet. In the middle of the night, I had to go and get my dry sleeping bag to get in. I weren't prepared. I've still got another dry quilt. My quilt was damp. I slept... I had water dripping on me at night. There was a horse with a terrible cough in the field next door as well. It kept coughing. I thought, poor thing. Anyway, it's a nice campsite though. It's a bit rough and ready. You get some hardened campers who are not used to young people, ravers. But they were quite toned down, I think. They had to ask one drunk boy to leave. He was very young and his parents apparently phoned up to ask where he was, and he was found across someone's drive asleep. You could build little log fires and everything here. Unfortunately, I've erased a whole side of a tape. Really, really annoyed. It was a whole side of when I was at Battle. The last parts of the... that part, so I don't know what was on that I'd have to trace back to find out what was on that, but it was nearly a whole side. I'd taped over it. I'd gone and put Hastings on there. I've still got a whole tape that's both sides of a Battle, but I think there's quite a lot missing now from one half, but never mind. It's my own fault for trying to... It's my punishment, really, for trying to pinch some of their tape recordings, I think. They've been erased. Oh, dear. Comeuppance. Right, I better get going. Quick commentary. I've arrived at a place called Sevenoaks, which isn't far from all the places I've got to visit.